So the device that's sending the information must make sure that it understands the complete end-to-end transmission before it even sends the information. So if I'm sending information and it doesn't get there, I'm going to be notified that packet too big. Packet too big message comes back to me. That's using ICMP. So with IPv6 ICMP, if I send a packet that's too big, it doesn't get fragmented by the router. The router says, hey, it's too big. And then it's going to let me know what the MTU size is. So then I'll resend the packet with a smaller MTU. So eventually my packet gets there. And then I'll know what the MTU is from end to end. And I'll send all the other packets at that size to make sure that they don't get dropped. So the routers will never perform fragmentation now. This is huge because it's going to ensure that our packets are more stable from end to end in regards to the communication. We don't have packets being broken up to be reassembled incorrectly on the other side. It reduces the amount of processing our routers have to do, so they're going to be more efficient. So the initial figuring out of the MTU, yeah, it might not be, you know, all that efficient, but once the MTU is figured out, then all the rest of the package can just go through and the router doesn't have to do any work after the fact. So it's more of a short-term loss for a long-term gain type of scenario. In the short term, we got to figure out the MTU, break, and then allow the device, the PC, to break up the information before it sends it, and then the routers don't have to do anything long-term. So that's why we got rid of identification flags and fragment offset, because that stuff doesn't have to be put back together from a packet standpoint, because the sending device is going to break it up originally and just send it out, and then the receiving device just puts it all back together. And that'll be more at the segment layer than having to do anything around here. We have our time to live field here for the IPv4. Do we have it with IPv6? Yeah, we do, but it's called the hop limit now. Remember what time to live is. It's really just a hop count. The original idea behind time to live for IPv4 was a timer. If we didn't get to the destination within a specific time, then the packet dies. Well, reality, it is what? It's a hop count. Number of routers we hop through. Every time a router touches a packet, it decrements the time to live by one. Well, now they call it hop limit here, but it's the same thing. It's the time to live field, just renamed as the hop limit. So payload length, we only care now, in this case with IPv6, about the payload length. So what is the payload length? It's our data portion. That's what that is. It's the data portion. So what are we carrying here in this packet? We're carrying a data portion that is this big. So that has been added here. And over on this side, well, we had our total length field. But we also had the header length field. We had a header checksum. All that's gone now. And all we have in return is this payload length field. Now, the next header field you can consider being similar to what? It's being similar to this protocol field with IPv4. So with IPv4, the protocol field says, hey, who are we passing it to at the transport layer? Who are we passing it to? We're going to be passing it to TCP. We're going to be passing it to UDP. The header field over here is, or the next header field's the same sort of idea. We're going to pass it to TCP. We're going to pass it to UDP. However, that is not always the case. And the reason why I want you to understand this is because we have the ability to add in what are known as extension headers. So if I want to add security, or I want to add other features and services while this packet is being transmitted, then I have the ability to say the next header is going to be right here. So I'm warning ahead of time that once you're done, we got to pass it over to here and then process the extension header. And if there's another extension header added on, because we can keep adding on extension header after extension header, then there'd be a next header field that keeps pointing. And then eventually at some point in time, there is going to be a next header field that says, oh, pass it to TCP or pass it to UDP. So if this is just a simple packet that we're sending and there's no extension headers, then the next header field says TCP or UDP or whatever the transport layer protocol is. But if we have extension headers added on, then it points to the next header, the next header, the next header, the next header. And then eventually you hit your segment of TCP, UDP, or whatever the transport layer has to be. So then we still have here, as we said, our source and destination address. Much, much bigger because we're dealing with 128 bits in total, source and destination address. And look, it was 64 bits long here. 64 bits wide versus in the past 32 bits wide. You might be saying, well, why is that? Processing capabilities nowadays, our operating systems, our processors, our memory, everything is designed based on what? 32 bits or 64 bits? Yeah, everything's designed based on 64 bits. When you download applications or you download features or services for your device, it asks you, are you running the 32-bit operating system or the 64-bit? Same idea here, right? But with IPv6, we're already looking towards the future. Everything's going to be 64 bits or maybe even bigger as we continue going. Who knows what the future holds for us? So they're already saying, let's make it 64 bits wide now so that way there when we have processing happen or we have memory storage happening, we are already in 64-bit chunks and everything just runs much more smoothly. So this is our new IPv6 header format. It's a good idea to keep in mind. It's 40 octets in size versus 20, 64 bits long instead of 32 bits long. And then these are the fields. It's much simpler, much lighter weight. And if you do need to add more features or services, you have extension headers that can do that for you.